Hi, welcome to this new video tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how you can use group in Jasper reports without using, of course, the group with SQL. And in order to, before doing that, let me show you what we are going to achieve in this tutorial. In this tutorial, you are going to have something like this, where you have a list of products here. We have a list of products that are grouped by the product line. And we have stuff like this one. In order to do that, let's go to and create a new report. Here we go to new, then select blank report. Next, here we give the report name just for group. Version 2. Next, here we can select the data source. If you don't know how to do this, you can watch my previous tutorial in the playlist. Then here we want to go, we don't want to write the SQL for now, show it in the later tutorial. Then we just go to select diagrams here, then go and to the database tables. You want to get from these product tables, you can just drag it and drop it here. So this here, instead of using select by products, we just go graphically, and we need the product group, product name, product line, product scale. We need the product vendors. We need the product quantity and the product price. Then next year, we need all these fields, and for now we don't need this group by here. We don't want to use it for now, we use it later. Then next, finish. Now here is our report. Now start the design. So here we are going to start by taking, we need the title to our reports, just enlarge it a bit. Then minus the heights. Here now we have, we can just like group in Jasper reports. We just write something like this one, and we go to the design, static text field, click center, and choose the font type and the font size. We get already something like this, not bad. We need the page header, we need the column header, and we don't need for now, we don't need the column footer, we can just minimize it. We don't need the summary, we can also minimize it. So here is all we have here. Then now we can just start collecting the field that we want. We need the product. We need the product code. We need the product name. We need the product vendors. We need the product quantity. So we can select these two to make some space. Select and then click left key, move them to the left. And lastly, we need the buy price. We can also do something here. Select this one, move it a bit to the left. Take this one here and move it to the left. And reduce it here. So we are almost there, move it again a bit. Yeah, now we need the product norm maybe larger, so we can just make this field bigger and the product vendors too. We need more space, reduce the quantity and give more space to this one. Then we can just do something now is to move them a bit up. Okay, you are there. Now we can just minimize the details to fit this one. And what we need, we can just design this thing this way, select all of them and so not that, go to advanced appearance. That, sorry, where is that? It's almost there, so we select here everything. So we can go down to the text fields and select the font. Let's select the font that we want, samples. Oh, we haven't selected this one. We go again, select samples. Yes, samples here, and we have also select the center, which is good for now. We just go back here. Yeah, the next thing that we have to add now is our group. So in order to add our group, we have to just collapse here and just create, select our report and create a new group. Here is group called product line, and we want to group by product line. We select that one. Next we add the header and footer. Here a new things to appear in our report. We don't need the footer for now, we just minimize, keep this one. And same thing as we did before, we select the rectangles. Here we select the rectangles. Here the purpose of this one is to give, to put a color, because without this one we cannot give a color to our design. So here we can just add the background color, select specific color that we want, something like this one. Not bad. And here you want to show the product names there. Here no calculations, just drag it and drop, and you just adjust this one to the width. And again, you go here to text field, select center, and scroll down, select the font type here and make it 20. And we are good to go. Now let's go and preview our reports. You can see that we have still different groups, many groups. It's not what we want. So in order to have only like one motorcycles and one classic cars, we need to go back to the design and click under these icons here and review again our designs. We come to this page here, scroll down, click on sorting. We have to sort by our product line, like this one automatically will be grouped. Then click OK. Now if we go again to the preview, you can see that now we have only one single group for the classic car and the next one for the motorcycles, for the trucks and buses. Yeah, and so on. So here is our report. I hope that it has been useful to you. In the next tutorial, I will show you how you can add some subtotals and grand totals. So if you like and have any problems, do not hesitate to drop your comments. Do not forget also to subscribe. Do not miss the next sessions. Stay tuned. Bye.